we had learned the prarthana shlokas earlier. We shall try to see the overall or the general meaning, bhavartha of these prarthana shlokas. Even for the exam, for this we will not have to write the pada padartha and anvaya etc. Basically, we shall see the prarthana shlokas and then the general meaning of this. Okay, so I will recite it. I request all of you to recite along with me. अजन्निर्विकल्पं निराकारमेकं निरानन्दमानन्दमद्वैतपूर्णं परन्निर्गुणं निर्विशेषं निरीहं परब्रह्मरूपं गणेशं भजेम. So if you I will just tell the padachheda so that you will be able to understand and try to make out the meaning also on your own. अजं निर्विकल्पं निराकारं एकं निरानन्दं आनंदम अद्वैत पूर्णम परम निर्गुणम निर्विशेषम निरीहम परब्रह्म रूपम गणेशम भजेम. द ओवरऑल एसेंस और द भावार्थ ऑफ दिस मीनिंग इज लेट अस प्रे टू लॉर्ड गणेश हु इज विदाउट बर्थ एंड डेथ. अजम मींस विदाउट बर्थ. ओके, सो इन संस्कृतम द वर्ड अजा इज देयर. इट ऑल्सो मीन्स अ गोट. अजह इज ऑल्सो अ गोट. So here, Aja is not a goat, but it is one which does not have, or one person who does not have a birth. He is Aja. Okay, and who is without form and attributes, Nirakaram. Okay, and then who is happiness. Okay, and then who is Brahman himself, Parabrahma Rupam, Ganesham Bhajema. Bhajema is the Kriyapadam, which means to say, let us pray to Ganesha. Let us all of us. It is Uttama Purusha Bahuvachanam. Okay, so if you see in this, all the words are in Dvitiya Vibhakti, and all of them are the attributes, or all of them are the Visheshanani for the word Ganesha. So Ajam Ganesham, Ajam Nirvikalpam Nirakaramekam Niranandam Anandam Advaitapurnam Param Nirgunam Nirvishesham Niriham Paraprahmarupam Tadrisham Ganesham Bhajema. One Ganesha who is like all these, let us bow down to him, or let us pray to that Lord Ganesha. That is the meaning of this Subhashitam. So I've tried to of this shloka. I've tried to explain it in a brief manner. And those of you who would like to try out padacheda, padapadartha, etc., you're welcome. Please do so. So it is for your own practice. With respect to the exam, padacheda and other things may not be asked for the shlokas. It will be mainly for the Subhashitam. But you will have to learn the overall meaning, the general meaning, the bhavartha of the shlokas, which will be asked actually. So hope this is clear. Now kindly identify also like which vibhakti each of them, and which is a visheshana pada, and what it is referring to, and what is a kriya padam. So so which I have told now. Let us try to see the same way for the second one. So mala sudha kumbha vibodha mudra vidya virajat karavari jatam apara karunya sudhambarashim shri sharadambam pranatosmi nityam. So this is the second subhashitam. So here if we see what is the kriya pada, it is asmi pranatah asmi pranatosmi. Pranatosmi is the action speaking word, which means to say I bow down. Okay, next, nityam means every day. I bow down every day or daily to whom? If you ask a question, kam pranatosmi, if you ask a question, whom do you bow down every day? It is sharadambam pranatosmi. So I will bow down to sharadambam. So this is in dvitiya vibhakti. Okay, 2.1, all the words are referring are the adjectives to this word Sri Sharadamba. Katham asti sa Sharadamba katham asti. How is this Sharadamba, if you ask a question? She is having mala sudha kumbha vibodha mudra vidya virajat kara varijatam. So who is holding a japamala, then a pot of nectar, the amrita, then gyana mudra and pustakam, in a book in her hands. She is not just that. What else, if you ask? What, once again, katham asti sa, if you ask a question, then apara karunya sudhambu rashim. Okay, so she is a ocean of compassion. Apara karunya, karunya is basically compassion, and then So that is how this Shararamba is. So this is the overall meaning of this shloka. So most of these shlokas, this is the first level of meaning that we are able to understand. Even if you consider the first shloka, which is Ajam Nirvikalpam, it is so much in depth if you actually go into that shloka with respect to the Advaita Vedanta itself. Shankaracharya, that is the beauty of the works of Shankaracharya. So whether it is for anyone or for a very scholarly person also, even just a basic shloka, you can see it in multiple levels basically. So at this level, we shall restrict ourselves to know the overall meaning. But as and when we proceed in our learning, we shall try to visit back again these shlokas, and then we will try to understand it further. The next shloka on Krishna. Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanura Mardanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadguru. Again here, Vande is the Kriyapadam. We have seen this as well. We have learned this. Vandate Vandete Vandante Uttama Purusha Ekavachanam. Vande means I bow down. I bow down to whom? Again, Kam Vande. Whom will you bow down to? Krishnam Vande. Kidrisham Krishnam. What kind of Krishna is he? So Vasudeva Sutam Krishnam Devam Krishnam Kamsa Chanura Mardanam Krishnam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Jagadgurum Krishnam Vande. So in this way, you can attach all the other words which are the adjectives to Krishna. So Krishnam Vande. I bow down to Lord Krishna, who is the son of Vasudeva, who killed Kamsa and Chanura, who brings delight to Devaki, and who is the teacher of the whole world. Jagadgurum. Jagadguru means the teacher of the entire world. Hope you're able to understand. So this way, whenever we read any other shloka which is not there as part of our syllabus, which you may be practicing every day as a parayanam, etc., try to identify now the vibhaktis in which the words are occurring and what is the kriyapadam in such shlokas, and then try to make a meaning based on that. So that is the overall purpose that all of us are learning Sanskritam, to apply it and understand whatever we read which is there in Sanskritam. So unless we try doing this or unless we do this exercise for every shloka that we read, etc., it will not be able to inculcate that practice. And of course, not every shloka is simple and easy. So there may be very complicated words, etc., in most of the other shlokas. But with time, you'll be able to understand them as well. Okay, we'll go to the next one, which is the Vyasa shloka. Namostu te Vyasa Vishala Buddhe Pullara Vindayata Patra Netra Yena Tvaya Bharata Taila Purtaha Prajvalito Jnanamayaha Pradipaha. So this is the shloka. Here, if you see, the words are not in Dvitiya Vibhaktihi. If you can identify, Hey Vyasa, it is all in Sambodhana Prathama Vibhaktihi. 1.1. Okay, 1 I will use for Sambodhana Prathama Vibhaktihi. So it is in okative case. That means to say, you are thinking Vyasa Maharshi is in front of you and you are asking, you are telling, you are bowing down to him and saying, Namostute Vyasa Vishala Buddhe, Hey Vishala Buddhe Vyasa Pullara Vindagata Patra Netra. And you are telling, Yena Tvaya Bharata Taila Purnaha Prajvalitaha Jnanamayaha Pradipaha. So you are directly conversing with Vyasa and you are bowing down to him that way. Namostu, Namaha Astu, Te. If you remember the forms, Yushmat Shabda, Tubhyam Te. The second form which we see in Yushmat Shabda in Chaturthi Vibhaktihi, that is this, okay? Here, why is Chaturthi Vibhaktihi used is because of Namaha. Whenever we use Namaha, the corresponding word will be in Chaturthi Vibhaktihi. Okay? Namostute Vyasa Vishala Buddhe. So, salutations to Vyasa, who has great intelligence, Vishala Buddhe, a broad or diverse knowledge. Okay? Whose eyes? Netra means eyes. Pulla Aravinda Ayata Patra Netra. So ones whose eyes are wide like the lotuses. And then you, by whom basically the knowledge, the lamp called knowledge is lit. By using what? By filling it with the oil, the taila, which is Bharata, which is Mahabharata. So Mahabharata is the oil through which you are actually lighting the lamp of knowledge. So that means to say, from Mahabharata, there is nothing else outside Mahabharatam. So yadi hasti tad anyatra, if something is written or if something is there in Mahabharata, then that means to say it can also exist elsewhere. Yenne hasti natat kutrachit, or that means to say whatever is not there in Mahabharata, that means to say it is not there anywhere at all. So that is the way we see Mahabharatam, or that is how scholars praise Mahabharata. That means to say it is a composite work which has many, many information and lot of knowledge content in Mahabharatam. And of course, Bhagavad Gita is part of Mahabharatam. So that again, Bhagavad Gita alone is answer to many questions that we face in our day-to-day lives. Okay, so we'll go to the next shloka on Shankaracharya. So Shankarupena Machittam Pankikritam Abhudyaya Kinkari Yasya Sa Maya Shankaracharyam Ashraye. Okay, Shankaracharyam Ashraye. So Shankaracharyam Ashraye is the Ashraye is the Kriyapada. So I bow down or I take refuge in Shankaracharya. Okay, Shankarupena is in Tritiya Vibhaktihi Ekavachanam. Try to identify. I'm just giving a few of the examples. Machittam, my mind. Panki Kritam, which was polluted by what? By whom? Yaya, that is Maya. Yaya, Mayaya, Panki Kritam. Sa Maya, that Maya is itself the Kinkari. Kinkari of whom? Kinkari Yasya. Tadrisha Shankaracharyam Aham Ashraye. So I take refuge in Shankaracharya, who is the master of Maya, or Maya is the slave or the servant of Shankaracharya. And my mind is polluted with doubts due to Maya. And hence I take refuge in that master, who is the master also for this Maya. So that is the meaning of this shloka. So hope this is clear. We'll go to the next remaining two shlokas. Vivekinam Mahapragnyam Dhairya Audarya Kshamanidhim Sada Abhinava Purvam Tam Vidyatirtha Gurum Bhaje. If you know the name of this Mahaswamigal, Param Pooja Shri Shri Abhinava Vidyatirtha Mahaswamigal. So Sada Abhinava Purvam. Abhinava Purvam is the name prefixed to Vidyatirtha. Tam Gurum, I bow down or I pray that I pray to that Guru. Bhaje is again Atmanepadi Uttama Purusha Ekavachana. I pray. So bhajate, bhajete, bhajante. So in that bhaje, okay. Whom do you pray if someone asks a question? I pray to or Abhinava Vidyatirtha Gurum Bhaje. So Kidrisham Gurum Bhaje. What kind of Guru is he if you ask a question? One who is Vivekinam Mahapragnyam Dhairya Audarya Kshamanidhim. Dhairya Audarya Kshamanidhim. Okay, one who is having a treasure of all these. Dhairya, Audarya and Kshama. And then Sada Bhaje. I always bow down to him. Okay, so I always pray to Srimad Abhinava Vidyatirtha Mahaswami, who is very wise, brave, generous and patient. Okay, that is the meaning of this. We'll have to add one more word here, which is always or every day. Sada means always. I always pray to Srimad Abhinava Vidyatirtha Mahaswami. So if you see all the words again in this shloka are in Dvitiya Vibhaktihi. All these are in Dvitiya Vibhaktihi. Okay. We'll go to the next one. Bharati Karuna Patram Bharati Padabhushanam Bharati Padamarudham Bharati Tirtham Ashraye. In the same way, this Ashraye is coming. Shankaracharyam Ashraye Bharati Tirtham Ashraye. Again, that also means the same way. So I take refuge in Sri Bharati Tirtha Mahaswamigal. If you ask again, Ki Drisham, Athava, how is this Guru, if you ask a question, then Bharati Karuna Patram, one who is blessed by Bharati. Bharati means Saraswati, Vagdevi, Samskata Mata, any of these you can know. Bharati is basically Vagdevi, Saraswati. So one who is blessed by Bharati, one who is blessed by Saraswati. Next, Bharati Padabhushanam, one who adorns the seat of Bharati. Bharati Padam Arudhavantaha. He has got the Bharati Pada. And then not only that, Bharati Padam Arudham. So one who has the name also Bharati, one who has adorns the seat of Bharati, he has got the Pada or that seat of Bharati itself. And Dadrisham Bharati Tirtham Aham Ashraye. I take refuge in such Guru Sri 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 Bharati Tirtha Mahaswamidal. So this is the general meaning of this shloka. Here in these kind of shlokas, there are various ways in which the Kavi would have beautified the shloka. That means to say, the same word repeats again and again, but with referring to something else. Okay, Bharati is Goddess Saraswati. Next, again where there is Bharati Padam, so that is the Bharati Pada, which is the stage, okay? And then Bharati Padam Arudham. Again, it is with respect to the same. And then Bharati Tirtham Ashraye, so the name of Guru Gadu. So in this way, there are various techniques people use when they compose poems or compose shlokas. So there some another shloka, if you want to see, Sharada Sharadam Bhoja Vadana Vadanam Bhuje Sarvada Sarvada Smakam Sannidhim Sannidhim Kriyat. This is one of the shloka which Jagat Gurus will use in most of their Upanyasam, etc. So in that, the word is repeated twice. Sharada Sharadam Bhoja Vadana Vadanam Bhoja Vadana Vadanam Bhuje Sarvada Sarvada Asmakam Sannidhim Sannidhim Kriyat. So every word is repeated twice, but the second meaning is completely different than the first one. So that is how they do this. So it is good and interesting to learn these aspects. And whenever you read any shloka, try to see what features are there or what different way of giving the same content or different way that they are using to represent or give it out in that shloka. So that will, as students of Sanskritam, that will help us understand the beauty of the language also. Okay. So that is the meanings of these shlokas that we wanted to cover today. So hope it is clear. So maybe we have a few more minutes. We shall revise the sankhyaha that we had learnt earlier. Okay, so let us go to the sankhyaha and let us revise it. And then we'll again go back for our question and answer session, and then we shall conclude today's class. So I shall ask some of the students to read out.